Hi, this is Sean. I'm going to be doing two demonstrations on how to record, render your images with wireframes. So, the idea is that for your demo reel purposes, you will want to be able to render out and show the topology of your objects. And one of the ways you can do it is potentially rendering out a play blast. So you could render out and right click on the timeline here, and you can output an AVI or a QuickTime or image file sequence. The issue that you'll face with this is that these aren't going to be anti-aliased wireframes. So the two other methods that I'm going to show you will accomplish that. So, another way to do this will be to go under Windows, Rendering Editors, and use the Hardware Render Buffer. And most people only think of this as a way to output hardware rendered particles, but you can actually render out wireframes from this. So, under the Render Options and the Attributes, you open up the Hardware Render Buffer attribute editor settings, and at the top here you give it a file name and you choose a name, number, and extension, what file type you're going to kick out, and whether or not you want to generate an alpha source. Of course, your image format has to be able to hold an alpha source, so if that is your goal, if you're going to do some compositing, then you'd probably want that on. But in this case, for this tutorial, really we just want to focus on the draw style. In this case, we're going to kick out a wireframe render. And also, let's specify what resolution. Usually, you're going to want to render out a higher resolution image. And so, as you can see right now, currently, the image is not anti-aliased. There's a lot of problems there. Plus, you probably would want to make sure that you're only showing the polygons in the foreground. You don't want to sort of have both. So, how do you deal with these two issues? The first is you turn on backface culling, because the hardware render buffer is really just pretty much taking an advanced screen capture of what's going on in the screen. So to turn on, so I'm hitting shift right click, polygon display, toggle backface culling. Then I'm going to go back into the attributes and I'm going to turn on line smoothing and multipass rendering and anti-alias polygons. I'm going to really crank up the render passes. And what's great about this is that even with this cranked all the way up, it still renders nearly instantaneously. So, and look at how nicely those polygons are. The edges are smoothed and anti-aliased. You can increase the edge smoothing a little bit. I mean, it sort of puts a little bit of a blur on top of the already anti-aliased image. So that's pretty good. Let me show you another way to do this. One of the standards that's being done right now is most people are rendering out ambient occlusion passes. And so this method will allow you to render out an ambient occlusion pass and easily translate your objects to have show the contours rendered. It's a little bit more technically intensive, so let's get going on it. So I'm gonna sort of set this. I guess one other final thing is the question would be, how do you before I move on to the next one, how would you specify different colors? Maybe you wanted this to be your wireframe to be white. Under Windows, Settings and Preferences, Color Settings, you can go into the active or inactive tabs, whether or not your object's been selected. And under modeling, you can specify that you want, like, the polygon surfaces. You know, what color do you want those to render out? So now when we render, you'll see they'll be output as white. So anyways, that's just an additional option. All right, so now let's move on to the next method. I'm going to also put my backface calling back to normal. All right, so this is a mental ray method here where I'm going to, as I said before, I'm going to output ambient occlusion with a wireframe. So just to show that this is the ambient occlusion pass, I'm going to nudge this in a bit so that we'll get some occlusion on this object. So I'm going to apply, shift right click. I'm going to apply a shader here, the surface shader. Another way to apply it would just be to simply right click, assign favorite material, surface shader. And then inside the color, the out color attribute of the surface shader, I'm going to apply a mental ray shader called the MIB underscore ambient occlusion shader. And that will generate the ambient occlusion pass. In order to get more samples, which will reduce the graininess on your ambient occlusion, you can turn this up. Usually the convention is doing it in powers of 2. So for this demonstration, I'm just going to kick this up to like 64. So you can go higher than that, depending on your needs. So I'm going to use the show input and output connections. And so you can see the connections that this has now. And in the upstream connection here, the surface shader, that's going to open up in the attribute editor here. We'll be able to sort of look at additional properties. And that's where you will want to go in and turn on in the mental ray tab. So in the surface shader attribute under contours here, you probably will have to open that up. Enable contour rendering. So there's a few other steps besides this in order for contour rendering to happen. First of all, you need to make sure you're rendering inside of the mental ray render. You probably will want to take the quality level up to production. And then under the features tab, you're going to go in and go down to the contours tab. You also need to enable contour rendering here. And in order to get really nice anti-aliased edges, you'll want to kick the oversampling up to 3 or 4. And then finally, you have to find, under draw by property differences, you're going to be rendering around all poly faces. So it's quite a few tabs to check, but once you've got that, we should be good to go. So let's do a test render here. So there's a few other additional pieces that we're going to sort of turn on. So the problem that we had is that the color of the wireframe was set to white. So what we did was we had a ambient occlusion pass with white wireframes on top of a basically white surface. And so, okay, and that should do it. So thanks again.